Welcome back, guys. Beamer and Son Garage. We're at the Indiana State Fairgrounds, the swap meet. And we're here with the Grove Street. It's Grove Street OG. Say hi to everybody, Grove Street.
Hey.
And we're checking out the engines they have here at the fairgrounds. That's super cool. Indy shirts. It's my first time here. So I'm kind of blown away by all the cars and you know, the building and all the people. And oh yeah, this is Scott Speed Shop's heaven over here. Look at this. And there's another building. I found out there's two buildings. So we got two buildings to go into, Grover. So this is just the first building. So look at these aluminum brace blocks.
Man.
Look at that.
Talk about a jewelry store.
Yeah, jewelry store, you said that right. Hemi head right there. Uh-huh. Oh, that's a nice head. It's a bare casting, so there's no, it looks like the seats are in it, but there's no valves. No springs, no keepers. Man, it's badass, man, in Indy. I like them valve covers. Man. This is like candy to me. Jewelry, you said yes, but the Beamer and Son Garage, this is candy. This is eye candy. Look at that head. Hello. Anybody there? Look at that intake router. Oh, Lord. Yeah, valve cover, Hemi valve cover. 426. Yeah, right there, 426 top pin kit. That's the whole kit. Man, that's badass. Here you got prices here. $500, $229. Stuff is, yeah. Stuff's pricey. Yeah, three deuces over there. And your 2-4 setup, tunnel rim. Yes, eye candy's putting it lightly. And we'll get to up there to swap meet and we'll start the first booth down the first aisle. Oh man. Yeah, that puts my mobile operational center to shame. That puts my, there we go, just the parts that people have, you know. So you're looking at used parts that somebody's selling, you know, not like that eye candy you're just looking at. But I mean, you're still looking at, there's a special transmission right there. It's an older transmission. It's a 64 and down, 727. It's got the intrusion on the back of the drive shaft, on the back of the tail shaft, and that's where the drive shaft bolts up. So that's the older version. I really need that transmission. Actually, I need to have that right there. For spare parts. This guy's got a good booth. A real good booth. How you doing, man? I got a YouTube channel, so I'm showing your stuff on YouTube. You don't care, do you? You want to be on YouTube?
Hmm?
You want to be on?
No. I'm going to break the camera.
You wouldn't break the camera, sir. Believe me. I'm just showing some of this stuff here at the, it's my first year, you know, 27 years that's going on. I just now found out about it. Well, actually, I found out last year, but I couldn't go. I'm looking for some windshield chrome for a Roadrunner. Dang, windshield chrome for a 70 Roadrunner? Oh, okay. I just thought I'd ask you. That's one of the things, the main things I'm looking for. Mickey Thompson valve covers. What are you getting on them valve covers?
$100?
Yeah, $100, yeah. That's a good price. Dog dishes, hubcaps. How much for the dog dish hubcaps?
What is it?
You got dog dish hubcaps? Look, you got a set of them.
I'll take $50.
For all of them? Man, that's a good price. That's a darn good price right there. Cornet 440, or the Cornet 500 emblems. We're eating the data up quick. And there's the bell houses, Vandership bell houses. Man, they got some good, look at the shifters. This guy's got some good stuff in his booth. This, I mean, it's the first booth I stopped at. And so far, it's turning out to be one of the best booths that I've stopped. Another Tasmania Devil format. What do you got over here? The sound of car parts hitting the concrete. Oh, she just bought some parts. Oh. My God, car. Ram emblem, Dakota emblem. Dodge truck stuff over there. A lot of Dodge truck air cleaner. A lot of cool stuff. Mirror. I gotta keep up with him because he's just zinging right past this stuff. And when I hit it, I stop my price stuff. I done priced a set of hubcaps and a bit of valve covers from that guy. Not really too high, but he's gonna make a buck. That's a plasma cutter. I wonder what the price is.
$2,000.
$200?
$2,000.
Oh my God. $2,000. Okay, that's that thing does. That's a TIG welder.
Yeah, TIG welder.
And an arc welder. And
plasma cutter.
Is it a plasma cutter too or not? I don't know if it's a
plasma.
It's a stick TIG. I don't think it does. I don't think it's plasma. I don't see a plasma. That is, that's the, what is that? All Star, owner's manual. It's basically a TIG welder, arc welder. It's not a plasma cutter, too. It's not, you're not going to put all that in one little small unit like that. $2,000. That's something Jimmy Morehouse and Morehouse Welding, you know, purchase something like that. That's a lot of money. That's more money I want to spend for a welder. I spent $500, but I'm not going $2,000. You know, here's a nice timing cover, Generation 1 Viper, 5V10. That's, you know, something I don't ever mess with. Yeah, pretty cool. But $2,000. Okay, we're gonna bounce around some more, and we're gonna look for Scott's Speed Shop, and I don't see him anywhere. So, we'll come back in a few minutes, guys. See you in a minute. Bye-bye.